its lecture rooms and classes came students from all over the world, and among them was a young girl. She was poor. She was beautiful. She had left her homeland and family, and here in Paris she was alone, haunted by dreams and invincibly eager.
Go out alone into space. Go out alone. You are 100 here, 100 students. But when it is time for you to think, you too will be alone, like the author of this equation, like Newton, let us say, or Galileo. Probably it will not be your good fortune to reach so high, to catch a star on your fingertips, to catch a star on your fingertips. But this you can share with them. You can learn to be alone with nature, with a ray of light, a piece of earth, a drop of rain. You can become aware of the earth whirling about the sun at the rate of 66,000 miles per hour. Aware that there's...
Robert has very little money and is, I believe, extremely talented. I thought you might have a workroom available at the School of Physics and Chemistry.
Well, I should be very glad. Unfortunately, at the moment, we are extremely crowded ourselves.
Oh, in that case.
However, my own workroom is quite large.
I would hesitate to ask you to share your own laboratory.
I have shared it with students before.
You have?
Yes, and some of them were very quiet and pleasant. On the other hand, one fellow was most troublesome. He used to whistle constantly.
Oh, I can assure you that this student is very serious.
And I should be very happy, of course.
Oh, I'll see if I can find her. I think you'll find that she's very sincere.
She? Twice. Stadowska. She's a girl.
Oh.
Well, I didn't find out in time. Always the continual struggle against woman, David. When we wish to give all our thoughts to some work which estranges us from humanity, we always have to struggle against woman.
Yes, sir. And women scientists are particularly unattractive, I find, sir.
Woman loves life for the living of it. In the world of abstract research, she's a danger, a distraction. She's the natural enemy of science.
There's no doubt of it, sir.
Women in science are incompatible. Women of genius are rare. True scientists can have anything to do with women.
No, sir.
Anyway, David, put her over there in that far corner.
Yes, sir.
And if you can, without being rude, inform her how important silence is to laboratory work.
Yes, sir.
You hope she doesn't whistle.
Madam Curie, you must realize that the board has given your application every consideration. However, the university has not an extensive budget for the creation of new laboratories and for the new equipment you ask for. You state that you and Dr. Curie have detected the presence of a new element, an active element. But unfortunately, you have given us no convincing proof of its existence.
We have demonstrated its existence experimentally. We have carried on our research intensively, except for 5 weeks in the autumn. In September, my daughter was born, and a week later, my husband had the misfortune to lose his mother. But the rest of the time we have devoted entirely to research.
And yet, in these 8 or 9 months, you have come no closer to any proof as to the existence of, what is the name of it?
My wife has named it radium.
Oh, yes, radium.
I should like to ask Dr. Curie a question.
Yes, Professor Roger.
This work will require quite a little time, will it not?
Yes, of course.
But you're already teaching the School of Physics and Chemistry. Madame Curie is teaching at the normal school at Sèvres.
It would be a formidable undertaking under the best of circumstances. Under these conditions, hardly seems promising.
And Madame Curie, in spite of her acknowledged abilities, is, if you will permit me to say so, young, inexperienced, and a woman.
Gentlemen, if you please, this remark seems to me entirely irrelevant. It is perfectly true that Madame Curie is young, that she has not had the experience that most of us have had, and as you say, she is a woman. But let me impress upon you, gentlemen, that she is a most unusual woman. I might say a
Well, a most unusual woman. You cannot classify her with that term. I have had the opportunity of observing Madame Curie very closely, and I can assure you, gentlemen, that she is a remarkable scientist, as scrupulous as she is brilliant.